Good morning, Creekwood Hawk!
My name's Simon. For the most part, my life is totally normal. I have a family that I actually like, and there's my friends. We do everything friends do. We drink way too much diced coffee while gorging on carbs. So, I'm just like you, except I have one huge-ass secret.
Hey! I like your boots! I said I like your boots! Goodbye!
Nobody knows I'm gay.
There's a really great line in this film that Simon says when he goes that announcing to the world who you are is really terrifying, because what if the world doesn't like you? Have you guys ever felt like you had to keep something about yourself because you were afraid people wouldn't like it?
Well, mine's the easiest because I was a closeted teenager, so yeah. I definitely kept my secret for a long time and denied it and thought maybe it'll go away and maybe it's just about a person, maybe I just need to find the right girl, and then that never happened and I found the right guy. But I went through all those emotions and on the other side of it though was a life that was even better than I could have imagined.
Oh yeah, sure. Anything for y'all?
Yeah, well I think I can't. You have a good
Alex.
Answer for this? You have a good answer for this, right?
I always got a good answer, honey. It's really hard to speak your truth. It's really hard to be exactly who you want to be. Personally, you know, I've always been an artist, and I was that kid who was always putting on shows and plays and all kinds of stuff, and I come from a family of really smart athletes, and it was a little bit of a challenge to be able to say, hey guys, I don't want to run track or play basketball like my brothers. I want to do plays, I want to do theater, want to finger paint and make paper mache sculptures and, you know, wear crazy prints and really kind of being yourself. And that's scary, especially with the people who love you the most, because they have an idea about who you are.
Yeah.
Especially your parents.
Absolutely.
Especially, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen the new post? About the closeted gay kid at school.
What?
Who do you think it is?
Can I call you back? Dear Blue, I'm just like you.
Social media plays a big part in this film, and when I went to high school, it was not this huge. We had like Zanga and MySpace in
right,
high school.
Right.
So it's like we certainly didn't have a website where people could post anonymous gossip or anything like that.
Count yourself lucky, I think.
That was my question. Well, I was gonna say, because if you're thinking about also like in some ways like Simon's situation, it was sort of beneficial, I guess. But like, I mean, do you think overall social media is more beneficial to teens in high school, or is it more harmful?
I think that's a very tricky question. Social media has changed so much about the way that we receive information and view the world. I think now in high school, kids are just hyper self-aware and hyper self-critical because their life is sort of online and they're constantly comparing themselves to other people. But on the flip side to that, I think that you're able to find communities a lot easier, and you're able to find people of like-minded views and of similar dispositions. So I think it's hard. In this film, you mainly see the negative side, but I think social media is a very powerful tool that can be used for good.
Sometimes I think I'm destined to care so much about one person, it nearly kills me.
Me too. I'm done living in a world where I don't get to be who I am. I deserve a great love story, and I want someone to share it with.
I love that a Ferris wheel plays such a big, like, yeah, I know. I mean, because I think it's actually ever since Everwood, that's when it's been for me. Like, I've loved Ferris wheels. I think they're such romantic spots. Wow. But what would each of you guys say is the best romantic spot?
Just in life?
Yeah,
in general?
Just anywhere. Like, if you want to take a date.
The beach.
Beach?
Yeah. PB&Js and juice boxes on the beach.
That's a good.
Very cute. Yeah. Most romantic spots. I like beach is a good one, or just sort of like, you know, picnics, simple things like that. The woods. Maybe not the woods, actually.
Yeah, what are you doing in the woods, Nick? Get out of there.
I like nighttime skylines. I think cities at night are very... there's a reason why they're always showing up in romantic movies also. There's something about them that has, you know, romance and possibility.
Have you ever been in love?
think so.
I love that Simon says, you know, I deserve a great love story, because it's true, like he and everyone really does. And that's why this movie, it's not just great, but it's also, I really think it's important because I think everyone also deserves to be represented.
Yes, sure.
So hopefully this movie is just the beginning of that.
Yes.
But moving forward, what other kinds of characters would you like to see represented in big studio films?
I'll just say, just in terms of, because we are the first studio film with a teen, LGBT teen at the center of it, that there's a lot of other letters in LGBT, you know?
Right.
And so, you know, we're happy to be the first. We wish that it had come a while ago, so that we would be on the 10th or 15th, you know? I mean, I've been in TV mostly, and we were doing some of the kind of stuff we're doing this movie we were doing a while ago, 10, 15 years ago on shows. And I think as a result, you've seen a lot more progress in a lot of network television than you maybe have in big budget films. And there's a lot of room for all different kinds of characters. I'd love to see a gay superhero.
Yeah.
You know, an LGBT James Bond, you know, any of those kind of things.
Yeah.
Like a trans James Bond.
There you go.
I would so watch that.
Be
100%.
Yeah.
Shake it, not stir.
That would be great.
Sugar on the rim.
Yeah, right. These last few years, it's almost like I can feel you holding your breath.
I'm supposed to be the one that decides when and where and who knows. That's supposed to be my thing.
Disclaimer, this is about to get romantic as hell.